Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. In this video, we will continue. We made three videos before. In the last three videos, showing you how Muslims are allowed to lie, and this is why we cannot trust Muslims answering you questions, because they are allowed to lie. They are allowed to lie to their wife, to their family, and to the enemy. And, you know, in any way, for them, you are an enemy as long as you are not a Muslim. And if you are a friend, you can see there, still they can lie to you, even if you are a friend, even if you are a Muslim. A Muslim a friend, a Christian, because a Christian cannot be a friend to a Muslim. Surah 5 verse 51, Surah 60 verse number 1, Surah 3 verse 28, etc. Muslims cannot take you as a friend. So always they have to consider you as an enemy and they have to lie to you. And you can go and watch the last three videos I made. Now in this video in here, we will see something very important. This is one of the most important ideas that Muslims believe about their God, coming from the Quran. You know, when we did read the Bible last time, we saw that Jesus saying that Satan is the, he was a murderer from the beginning, and he is the lie and the father of lies. The father of lies. This is very important, and this is true. And actually, the Quran is saying to us that Allah is the father of lies. How? In Surah 7, verse number 99, it says, for people who speak Arabic, you know, you can read. And for people who speak English, as you see, it's in front of you, you can read too. And so do they feel secure from God gloating that He is drawing them by degrees through graces and then sizing them suddenly? None feel secure from God, by the way, it's Allah in here, not God, gloating. But the people who they are losers. Now, what does this mean? The word "gloating" in here, it's not really accurate. You know, the word in Arabic, makara, it's mean deception or deceiving. So, those who do trust Allah, that He will not deceive them. Allah is not the one you can trust His deceive. And the one who trusts His deceive is the losers. Which means the one who will feel ever that he is secure from Allah, deception, not action only, deception. Listen carefully. Like, if a Muslim will come to me and say, you know what, okay, this is in the judgment day, that's Allah. And here is saying that suddenly He will seize them all and He will take them to hell. Well, we believe this in this as a Christian too. But we don't believe that God is going to seduce people to do bad things. Read with me, sir. Allah will seduce them by grace. He is drawing them. This is His deception. So Allah, He seduce you to do bad things. Now guys, who is the one who seduce? I thought it's Satan. You know? Allah, He will seduce you to do those bad stuff. And then suddenly, Allah will capture you. It sounds like Allah is doing fishing or hunting. He put a trap for you. Huh? He is making the trap. And not only making the trap, He is seducing you to come to the trap. Which means, He is not telling you this is a trap. He's not telling you this is bad, this is wrong. No, He put it there and He seduced you. And when you get to bite that trap, Allah will size you. Who is Allah then? You know, when God, He told Adam not to eat from that tree, it wasn't a trap. Because He told him, if you eat from this trap, this is a tree, you know, you will not happy at all. I will punish you. Trap is something you don't know it's a trap. Otherwise, you will not go there. So what Allah is doing here, He is drawing you by degrees, you know, and through graces. Like, you know, like if you are a little cat, and Allah, He tied something for you with a line in His hand, and each time you keep getting close to that thing, the piece of cheese or whatever or meat, Allah He draw it to His side, and then you follow it, and Allah He draw it to His side, then you follow it until you arrive next to Allah and Allah capture you. This is a deception of Allah. So when He is saying that those who trust that Allah will not deceive them, they are the losers. So all Muslims, they will never trust the deception of Allah. This is why Umar ibn al-Khattab, the Khalifa, the best friend of Muhammad, he said, "La amanu makr Allah." He and in Muhammad, yes, they said that too. "La amanu makr Allah." I cannot trust the deception of Allah, the deceiving of Allah. Now I will show you how Allah, He seduced you to do things so He can destroy you. You know, and this is mean that Allah is a Satan. This is the book of Al-Fiqh. Okay, and this is a Muslim approved book big time, and no Muslim can say it's a lie. And this is the official website of Saudi Arabia and the Department of Fiqh al-Islam, which means the knowledge of Islam. Now in here we will see a story reported by Muhammad himself about a man. He was going to go to pray. And when he was going to pray, he saw a Christian woman. Listen to this. He saw a Christian woman. Let me show you where I'm reading so we can read together. And here you will see two stories that a guy, he converted to Christianity because he fell in love with a woman. And right away after he converted, Allah, He put disease in his heart. Or He made him sick. Then he was thrown in the street, asking, "Please help." Some of the people, they walked by and they said to him, "What happened to you?" Then what he said to them, the fitna. Here we go, fitna. You know, fitna, which means deception, happened to him. That he did converted to Christianity, and now he cannot even recite one word from the Quran. Allah is forbidding him from reciting the one word from the Quran, which is a lie. I read Quran every day. You know? So he wished he can recite one letter even from the Quran, but he cannot. And he cannot even remember it. And then after a few moments, he passed by him and he found him dying and his face was to the east. And then he died. His soul came out. Man, you see the deception of Allah? So the deception of Allah, Allah, He put in front of this man a Christian woman, made him love her. Allah seduced him. This is the plan of Allah. Seduced him by this woman. This man, he left Islam for this woman. And because of that, Allah, He made him die. And even he cannot recite the Quran. Another story. There is a guy, he is a scholar in Islam. He used to go to the mosque to pray every morning. And when he was going to do azan, which means to call for a prayer, he saw a Christian woman from the top of the mosque. So he fell in love with her. He went to her, asking her to sleep with him. She refused. Look how filthy he is. Then he said, "Well, what about marry me then?" This she said, "I cannot marry you. My father will not agree because you are a Muslim." Then he said, "I will convert to Christianity." Then she said, "Okay, if this is what you will do, this is fine." He converted and they promised him that he will marry her. And in the same day, look at this, in the same day, his foot like slip. Something slippery, supposedly. It slipped and fell down and he died. According to this, this is the deception of Allah. You see how Allah deceive you? And Allah deceive you and right away He kill you. Right away. And you can tell all those stories is a bunch of garbage, a bunch of lies created by Muhammad to fool those people. And you know, this can't be true. There's a lot of people, they left Islam already. There's, according to Al Jazeera TV, 16,000 Muslims leaving Islam a day. Why God, Allah is not doing a slippery for their foot and they fell down and die? But the most important here now, that we found that Allah, He seduced you to do evil according to this chapter in the Quran. And when you been seduced by Allah, not by Satan. Now we prove that Allah and Satan is one. Because the one who seduced you to do bad things according to this verse is, you know, it's Allah. It's very clear. Now who's Satan then? What's Satan do? If the one who seduced me to do bad things, and as you see, marrying a Christian woman and converting to Christianity is an extremely bad thing. You became filthy. Allah will kill you, will make your foot slip. So if Allah is the one who seduced me, if Allah is the one who deceived me, if Allah is the one who lied to me, who is Satan? I hope you did learn something new today. Jesus is Lord, and Allah is the Makkar, which means the deceiver and the deception. Amen. I